It's Jordyn here from Byte Camp. Welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a really cool background in FlipaClip for your short film. And before I do that, please, please, please go and press that subscribe button below. It really helps us out and it ensures that you don't miss out on future content. And we'll be finishing our short animations soon. So let's jump on our tablets. All right, so here I've got my background for my first scene of my video. And as you can see, I've got a lot of different textures, a lot of small details that make it pretty visually appealing to the eye. So as you can see, my trees are nice and fluffy, whereas my ground is a solid color. I've got the vines in the trees and the small plants in the background there. Just small things that really convey where my story is taking place. So my story is taking place in the jungle. As you can see, I haven't overcrowded my background. I don't have too much stuff there because I don't want to take away from the story that I'm telling, but I do have enough details that I know where I am. All right, so I'm going to show you how to create a few of these things. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new FlipaClip document separate from any of the animations that we've done. And this is where we're going to keep all of our backgrounds. As you can see here, I've actually created a few different layers. So I have a layer for my sky or my back background. I have a mid-ground layer. So that's in between the background and the foreground. And then I have a foreground layer, and my foreground layer is going to be closest to my camera. Those different layers, we should fill up a little bit on each layer just to add a little bit of depth to our animation. So I'm going to start with my sky, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into my pen tool, and I'm going to click on that pen. As you can see, some different options show up. I'm going to grab my paintbrush. And here I'm going to pick my color of my sky and I'm going to change the opacity. I'm going to lower the opacity quite a bit because I want to give this kind of see-through effect. So I'm pretty happy with that. So let's go back to our pen tool and let's switch to our midground. All right, so as you can see, my path is smaller on the right hand of my screen versus the bottom left hand side here, and that's because that is where my camera angle is set. So when something gets farther away, it looks smaller, and when it gets closer, it's bigger. All right, and now I'm going to add my trees into my midground, so I'm gonna switch back to my paintbrush tool. All right, so now I'm going to move into my foreground. And as you can see here, I have these big plants at the front corner here. That's what I'm going to add in now. If I didn't want to redraw this, I'm going to select it with my lasso tool. I can copy and paste it. And as you can see, it's only copied what layer I have selected. So since I wasn't on my mid-ground layer, if I was on my mid-ground layer, it would copy the ground instead of this plant. I can flip it around using these tools on the side here on the right-hand side. And of course I can resize it. All right, that's all that I have for you today. I hope that you've come up with something that you're really happy with. You've got a really cool background ready for your first scene of your movie. And in the next video, I'll be showing you how to use these backgrounds in your animations, as well as touch on secondary actions. So we'll see you next time. Don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss out. Bye, everyone.